Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. O magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. This is the day which the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Bless the Lord who forgives our sins. God's mercy endures forever. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. And you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength. This is the first commandment, and the second is like, namely this, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. There's no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us and write all these laws in our hearts. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. Here also what St. Paul says, The saying is true and worthy of full acceptance, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments, and to live in love and peace with all people, meekly kneeling upon our knees. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbors in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our deliberate fault. We have not sufficiently walked according to the mind of Christ. We have named the name of Christ, but have not departed from iniquity. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that has passed, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Collects and the Ministry of the Word. The Lord be with you. Almighty and everlasting God, who in your tender love towards mankind sent your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, to take upon him our flesh and to suffer death upon the cross, grant that we may follow the example of his patience and humility, and also be made partakers of his resurrection, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Almighty and merciful God, it's nothing that you have made, and forgive the sins of all those who are penitent. Create and make in us new and contrite hearts, that lamenting our sins and acknowledging our wretchedness, we may receive from you, the God of all mercy, perfect forgiveness and peace, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Old Testament reading is taken from Isaiah chapter 50, comments reading from verse 4. The Lord God has given me the tongue of the learned, that I should know how to speak to a word in season to him that is weary. He wakened morning by morning, he wakened my ears to hear as the learned. The Lord God has opened my ears, and I was not rebellious. Neither turn away back. I gave my back to the smiter and my cheeks to them that plucked off the hair. I hid not my face from shame and spitting. But the Lord God will help me, therefore shall I not be confounded. Therefore have I set my face like a flint, and I know that I shall not be ashamed. He is near that justified me. Who will contend with me? Let us stand together. Who is my adversary? Let him come near to me. Behold, the Lord God will help me. Who is he that shall condemn me? This is the word of God.
The epistle is written from the epistle of Paul to the Philippians, chapter 2, beginning at the 5th verse. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant. I was made in the likeness of man, and being found in the fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Wherefore, God also had highly exalted him, giving him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of things in heaven, things in earth, and things under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of the Father. This is the word of God.
Holy Gospel is written in the Gospel according to St. Matthew, chapter 21, the reading from verse 1. As they approached Jerusalem and came to Bethphage, on the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, "Go to the village ahead of you, and at once you will find a donkey tied there, which are caught by her. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, tell him that the Lord needs them, and he will send them right away." This took place to fulfill what was spoken through the prophet. "Say to the daughter of Zion, see, your king comes to you, gentle and riding on a donkey, on a colt, a foal of a donkey." The disciples went and did as Jesus had instructed them. They brought the donkey and the colt, placed their clothes on them, and Jesus sat on them. A very large crowd spread their clothes on the road, while others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road. The crowds that went ahead of him and those that followed shouted, "Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest!" When Jesus entered Jerusalem, the whole city was stirred and asked, "Who is this?" The crowds answered, "This is Jesus the prophet from Nazareth in Galilee." Jesus entered the temple area and drove out all who were buying and selling there. He overturned the tables of the money changers and the benches of those selling doves. "It is written," he said to them, "My house will be called a house of prayer, but you are making it a den of robbers." The blind and the lame came to him at the temple, and he healed them. But when the chief priests and the teachers of the law saw the wonderful things he did, and the children shouting in the temple area, "Hosanna to the Son of David," they were indignant. This is the word of the Lord.
Speak, O Lord, through me under the unction of the Holy Spirit, and cause us to hear, understand, and put it into our hearts, and be obedient to your word, so that we will not lack in that which Jesus have exemplified, a life to live, a way to follow, and the gospel to proclaim. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank God for another Palm Sunday celebration. I'm delighted to bid all of us happy Palm Sunday celebration and joyful, triumphal entry of Jesus Christ into our hearts, our homes, his church, and unto the society we are in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Are you here? I believe in amen.
Amen.
Are we happy to be alive today?
Yes.
How many of us celebrated Palm Sunday last year? Hallelujah.
Amen.
You will hear celebrate Palm Sundays, and the meaning of it shall be realized upon your life, upon my life, upon our life, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Excuse me. The topic of the sermon is Christ's simplicity and humility. Christ's simplicity and humility. The distinguishing characters of Jesus Christ are depicted in his choice of riding into Jerusalem to fulfill God's plan and purpose unto the salvation of man, Today is the beginning of Passion Week. From this night, Jesus was betrayed, arrested, and he suffered unto the Calvary, where he died. But then, he rode triumphantly into Jerusalem, riding on a donkey. The stanza two of the hymn, the gradual hymn, say, why a king riding in a donkey? Why a king wearing no fine crown? Where the drums, where the high sounding cymbals? If a king is riding into a town, Jesus Christ is the Lord of Lords, the King of Glory, the owner of the heaven and earth, and all in them contain, according to Psalm 24. But he chose to ride into Jerusalem on an ass. There were other domestic carriage animal in his time which he could have used, but why donkey in our contemporary time? King James say ass. Of course, he could have used elephant, which is very big. He could have used camel, which is very tall and big. He could have used horse or even chariot. Why donkey? Donkey is a symbol of simplicity and humility. And that's why the topic is talking about Christ's simplicity and humility. Two unique characters put together like twins. Why didn't he use camel? Camel could carry load and travel miles across the desert. Camel has the storage capacity of water that could last for days. Host, but one thing with camel is camel can carry load and endure long distance, but it grumbles. Camel grumbles. You know, people, when they are walking, they are grumbling, they are complaining, they are grudging. So Jesus was not using animal like that. What about elephants? So big. Synergy of eyes. Jesus was not here for show off. What about horse? Horse is used for war. Jesus did not go for physical war. He used donkey. Donkey is a symbol of humility and simplicity. The text is Matthew chapter 21. I will read verses 4 and 5. All this was done that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophet. That the prophet Zechariah in Zechariah chapter 9 verse 9, saying, tell ye the daughter of Zion, behold, thy king cometh unto thee meek. That is summary of simplicity and humility. And sitting upon an ass, and a colt, the foal of an ass. Go to Philippians chapter 2, the epistle read to us, or read together. Chapter 2, verses 7 and 8. That made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men, and being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Simplicity and humility personified. Can you compare that with our leaders today? President, governors, local government chairman, even the chancellor. I remember sometime along this Ikorodu Road that was Babangida that was passing, and the whole road was shut for about an hour, just waiting for him to pass. And we know the number of siren and escort riders that will go ahead of him and follow behind him, because the president has come to the state. Recently, when Tinubu came to commission this Gbadabina hospital, here was closed because the president came. But look at the eternal King of Glory, the Lord of all, the Lord mighty in battle, glorious in holiness. He chose to ride on a donkey. Understand, there were wild donkey, but he used domestic donkey. He used domestic donkey. And that donkey was tied, owned by people. And Jesus said, go and bring it, and nobody stop it, because the earth is of the Lord and fullness thereof. He could have used any other thing he wanted, but he chose to use donkey, which is a symbol of simplicity and humility. Christ emptied himself of his eternal divine position and possession. His titles, in the epistle we read, he said that he did not think himself to be robbed, to be equal with God. He has the same quality with the Father and the Spirit. But this sin, he emptied, he relinquished them and took the nature of a servant. I was found in a fashion of man. As a being found in the fashion of man, he humbled himself and became obedient. Understand here that man was fashioned to be humble. Jesus came in the flesh. Man was fashioned to be humble. Why? Because we are molded from the dust. If we realize that we are nothing but dust, but for the Spirit of God in us, so there is no room, no reason why we should puff up. The opposite of simplicity and humility is pride, arrogance, boastful, you know, ostentatious living, flamboyance, and all these things. That is contrary to the quality of being simple and humble which Jesus Christ exemplified. And this is the Christ that breed Christian. And if there is anything like master, like servant, like father, like son, like Christ, like Christian, we have to exhibit the same simplicity and humility that is in Christ Jesus. In Matthew chapter 11, verse 29, Jesus said, take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and you shall find rest for your soul. Here he called us to portray the same character that he has shown us. Jesus did this thing as the example for us to follow. Praise the Lord. Simplicity and humility entails chasteness, to be pure, purity. It comprises contentment, moderation. So let your moderation be known by all men. It includes comportment, discipline, how we carry ourselves humbly and simply in the society we are. Christ was not known for puffing up or bragging, making noise in the street, or fighting. Simplicity includes lowliness of heart, and that is lack of pride, arrogance, pomposity, but loyalty and submission to God's will. Obedience to constituted authority. Jesus came in the volume of the book, I recently concerned him, to do the will of the Father. And he said, as my Father has sent me, so I send you. We are to do the will of the Lord Jesus Christ, and he did the will of the Father. And he did all this thing in simplicity and humility. Simplicity and humility. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You know, when you were teaching us on the Lord's Prayer, he taught us to pray, let your will be done on earth as it is done where? In heaven. Who are those doing it in heaven? If you go to Revelation chapter 4, verses 8 and 9, Isaiah chapter 6, 1 to 3, you see the angels, the loyal angels, the living creatures, 24 elders, how they worship God in humility. The Bible says, with their wings, they cover their face. You can imagine the bigness of the wing of eagle. That of angel is more than that. And when they cover their face, that is humility. And today we come with wanton face before God. Bible talk about having shamefacedness. The angel fall down before the Lord. And when we sing the song, all the saints adore thee, you know, we say casting their golden crowns before, just as the angels worship of veiling their face. And the Bible teaches us, when we worship God, men should, when we start to pray and prophesy, men should cover their head. But today, because position and title, maybe as a king or whatever, you know, we cannot do that. And we may can't humble ourselves before God when they pray and worship because of our hairstyle and do and all those ones. Let's learn from the angels. And let's follow our master Jesus Christ. Humility, humility and simplicity. It has great gain. If we follow the step of Jesus Christ, those rewards and the blessings shall not elude us. Praise the Lord. In Isaiah, the Old Testament we read, he said, you give me the tongue of the learned. That wisdom, that discretion. You know the learned men have the reason. They know the consequence of everything. He said, to speak the word in season. Simplicity and humility attracts the presence and the power of God. In 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 5b, it says, put on the garments or cloak of humility. For God resists the proud and gives grace to the humble. We need the grace every moment of our time. But if you're asking, if you are expecting this grace, humble yourself. The Bible says, underneath you is the everlasting arm of the Lord and will lift you up. He said, he dwells in holy and high place with those who are of contrite heart and broken spirit. That is humility. That is simplicity. Praise the Lord. Humility and simplicity accords divine riches, honor, and life. Proverbs 22, verse 4. It says that humility attracts riches, honor, and life. Humility. Hallelujah. Now in the epistle, but before then, when somebody lives a simple life, he saves himself from unnecessary stress. Simple life. Simple life. It saves you unnecessary stress. Many of us will go borrowing because we want to satisfy people. Whether wedding, whether marriage, whether burial, you must not borrow if you live a simple life. You don't need to please man. Please God. Now, the climax of it, as seen in the life of our master, is exaltation. Can somebody say exaltation? Last year, our theme was divine word. Have you forgotten? Last year's theme in this church. Hello? Divine elevation. Exaltation, upliftment. Look at verse 9 of the Philippians chapter 2 we just read. Let's take it again. Because that's the climax. Philippians chapter 2 verse 9. Wherefore, what does it mean? Because of humility, because of simplicity of Christ, God also has exalted, highly exalted him, and given him name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus Christ every knee should bow, of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of the Father. What according him that is simplicity and humility. Now we can have that because the grace is sufficient. We have the Holy Spirit with us here to live a simple, simple life, humble life as we serve the Lord, especially in the church, then in the society. Praise God. Simplicity and humility. It is a unique Christian character. It's a Christian virtue that accords exaltation, upliftment. By the presence of God, you have boldness. You have unction. You have favor of God. If God be for us, who can be against us? Brethren, we need this life to live. Let's not just end up commemorating his triumphal entry into Jerusalem. Has he triumphantly entered my life? Do I possess the victory of Jesus over pride, over arrogance? Many of us are not submissive. Many of us are unteachable. We feel that we have arrived. We are above every other. That is not what Jesus has taught us. So today, we should, you know, pray that God will grant us realization and let this remain in our life. If you are hoping to meet with him in the sky when he comes for the church, you must be humble. If you are proud, he will resist you. He will reject you. May that not be our portion in the name of Jesus Christ. So I ask you, as I have asked myself when God was ministering to me, oh ye Christian, where are your simplicity and humility? Oh ye Christian, where is your humility? We are the simplicity. Because Christ was humble. Christ was simple. Where is mine? Where is yours? May the grace of God abound upon us to live Christ's life and to do his work. In the name of the Father, amen, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Lord be with you. Let's affirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven by the power of the Holy Spirit. He became incarnate of the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. For the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Lord, we lift up your name with our hearts full of praise. Be exalted, O Lord our God. Hosanna in the highest. Glory, glory, glory to the King of Kings. Glory, oh glory, glory to the Lord of Lords. Lord, we lift up your name with our hearts full of praise. Be exalted, O Lord our God. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, have mercy. We are with Christ in his suffering for forgiveness for the many times we have denied Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For grace to seek out those habits of sin, which means spiritual death, and by prayer and self-discipline, to overcome them. Let us pray, Lord. Lord, have mercy. For those who make laws, interpret them, and administer them, that our common life may be ordered in justice and mercy. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For those who have the courage and honesty to work openly for justice and peace, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For those in the agony of isolation, that they may find support and encouragement, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For those who are weighed down with hardship, failure, or sorrow, and feel that God is far from them, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For those who are tempted to give up the way of the cross, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. That we, with those who have died in faith, may find mercy in the day of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. The Lord be with you. Please let us rise for the peace. Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which the earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Amen. Yours, Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendor, and the majesty. For everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own do we give you. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. This is right to give him thanks and praise. It is indeed right. It is our duty and joy at all times and in all places to give you thanks and praise, Holy Father, Heavenly King, Almighty and Eternal God. Through Jesus Christ, your only Son, for he is your living Word, through him you have created all things from the beginning and formed us in your own image. Through him you have delivered us from the slavery of sin and given him to be born as man and to die upon the cross. You raised him from the dead and exalted him to your right and on high. Through him you have sent upon us your holy and life-giving Spirit and made us a people for your own possession. And now we give you thanks because through him you have given us the spirit of discipline that we may triumph over evil and grow in grace. Therefore, with angels and archangels and all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and as we follow his example and obey his command, grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us his body and blood, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Therefore, Heavenly Father, we remember his offering of himself made once for all upon the cross and proclaim his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension as we look for his coming in glory. We celebrate with this bread and this cup his one perfect sacrifice. Accept through him, our great high priest, this our sacrifice of thanks and praise. And as we eat and drink these holy gifts in the presence of your divine majesty, renew us by your Spirit. Inspire us with your love. And unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, through him and with him and in him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honor and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Amen. We're one body, as we'll share in the one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, give us your peace. We do not presume to come to your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our unrighteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under your table, but you are the same Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may have more dwell in him and he in us. Amen. Draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave you, and his blood, which is shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your heart by faith with thanksgiving.
Thank you.
time once more for us to bring before the Lord our kingdom seed. Please stand up with our kingdom seed as we trust that the Lord will use this which we are given to raise many more soldiers for him, many more people that will stand for him even in the end times like this. Let's pray. Let's stand as we pray. Precious Redeemer, we thank you. We give you praise and glory. We thank you because of your love and for your mercies. We thank you, God, for this opportunity that you have given unto us again to partner with you. We ask, oh God, that as we give our kingdom seed this morning, Lord, that you will bless us return in the name of Jesus. Amen. You will bless us bountifully in the name of Jesus. Bible says, oh God, that if we go sowing in tears, that doubtless we will come back rejoicing, bringing in the sheaves. This shall be our portion in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, because you have heard us. In Jesus Christ's mighty name we pray.
Jesus said, "My Father, if it is possible for this cup to be taken away unless I drink it, may your will be done." And as his taught us, our Savior Christ, so we pray as we kneel, "Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. So in celebration of him who rode in lowly pomp. Pomp, nevertheless, but lowly in deep humility, who sacrificed, who gave up everything for us, that we might win and gain and be with him in glory, who is highly exalted. Shall we come forward as the Guild of Stewards brings the offering back to the front and the band strikes up the chord with a dance in our step, a song on our lips, and praise in our hearts, and deep adoration as we bring forth our Sunday offering with a collection and scholarship fund.
You are the Lord, that is your name. You will never share your glory with any man. You will never share your glory with anybody. Almighty God, that is your name. You are the Lord.
Let us pray. Our gracious God, we thank you this morning, especially for the grace you have showered on us to see this year Palm Sunday. We thank you for our walk. We thank you for all the journey we made this week. We thank you for everything you have done in our lives, individually and collectively. Lord, accept our thanksgiving in the name of Jesus. Lord, we brought our Sunday collection, welfare offering, and scholarship fund. Bless and sanctify in the name of Jesus. Lord, we pray for our work, that no calamity will befall any one of us in our working places in the name of Jesus. That whatever we lay our hands on this week, We will prosper. We'll be successful. In the name of Jesus. Thank you for hearing us. In Jesus' name we pray.
So now please let us bring forward to the altar, to the throne of grace, our tithes, maintenance and project card, as we continue to rejoice and give thanks and praise to our King of Kings and Lord of Lords, our Savior, as the band again strikes up the chord.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my Lord. Whatever I am now, it is right with grace. Many accompany, many appreciate. Whatever I am now, it is right with grace. Thank you.
We thank you, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, great provider, for the blessing upon your children. Those paid their tithe online, and those who are here, those who their project card and maintenance card, honoring you, they give them and accept their offering. And according to your promises, O God, of course, grant them expansion of their business. We pray that the source of this money shall never run dry. Let the fountain continue to flow. And they themselves be channel of blessing to others in the name of Jesus. Thank you for answering our prayers. In Jesus Christ's name we are prayed. Amen. Remain blessed.
Hallelujah. That's what our soul will be. That's what our soul will be.
For all those who are here for their birthday, Thanksgiving, wedding, anniversary, those who traveled and God Almighty accorded journey mercies to, better stay, you want to step forward for one thing or the other that God Almighty has done for you, especially through your children, your grandchildren, please let's step forward for all blessings, for all blessings. The band, please.
Darling Jesus, darling Jesus, oh my darling Jesus, you're the one that you know. I love you so, my darling Jesus, oh my darling Jesus,
you're the one that you know.
Darling Jesus,
oh my darling Jesus, oh my darling Jesus,
I love you so,
oh my darling Jesus, oh my darling Jesus.
Jesus,
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus
Father. We thank you for the various ways that you have blessed us. Lord, we are returning thanks to you, Father, for those that you granted another year to their age. We ask, O God, that you will bless this, their new age, in the name of Jesus. Thank you for those that you elevated, O God, in their workplaces. We pray, O God, that this, their new position, they will continually glorify you. And Lord, their blessings shall continue to abide with them, Lord, in Jesus' name. Thank you for those that you granted joining mercies to. Thank you, Father God, for the miracle of sleeping and waking. We all thank you for the ways, O God, that you have blessed us. And our scripture says, O God, that your blessings make it rich and add no sorrow. We pray and decree that no sorrow will be added to these our blessings in the name of Jesus. Lord, we continually rejoice in you, O God, because you have blessed us and you will make us rich. Rich in love, rich towards you, rich in our relationship, O God, with you in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father, that you continually make us, O God, to triumph, even as we celebrate Palm Sunday this day. Blessed be your name, Father, forever. In Jesus Christ's mighty name we have prayed.
Amen. We invite our mothers to step forward with their sacrifice card. Women, sacrifice card. Women, sacrifice card. The band, please.
In the busy beneath way, Anansi, hallelujah. Anansi, hallelujah. Jehovah, Mary,
above all praise and all majesty, Lord, above all glory seated, who nevertheless came in deep humility for our sakes, emptied himself. Look with mercy and grace and compassion upon these your maid servants before your altar. Bless them beyond anything they can ask, imagine, conceive, or desire, beyond above their wildest dreams. Make a way for them, whether deserts or river or ocean or wherever. Continue to make a way for them. Go before them, smooth the paths ahead of them, cause the lines to fall in good and glorious places. Continue to grant your goodly, your excellent inheritance. May they be rooted and grounded in you. May all recognize that they have been with you. Set your seal upon them, that all may know that they are yours. Mark them with the marks of Christ, who has branded them his forever. Accept their offering, sanctify them, their offering, all that they are, all that they ever will be, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
When I was worried and couldn't sleep, he was walking beyond the senior. Even before I pray, to every tarry, answer me.
Next Sunday is Easter, and we shall all live to witness it in Jesus' name. You know that expectedly at the end of the month, you like to give thanks to God. So that is why I'm craving your indulgence that our best bet is to use today's platform for our monthly thanksgiving. Are we together? Thank you. Let us stand as we pray. Monthly thanksgiving, everybody. Let us stand as we pray. Our eternal God, ages, we lift up your holy name because you have done this for us on the plot of gold. Our moment, your provision, your enablement in all its ramifications stands us out. Lord, we could flash back when we started the beginning of this march. Father, Lord God Almighty, a lot of people are dropped on the way. We are not making jest of anybody, but we are using this opportunity to say, hallowed be thy name. Lord, for preserving us, our family members, wherever they may be, take our glory in the mighty name of Jesus. For putting food on our table, despite the hardship in the country. Thank you, Lord God Almighty, because you continue to fulfill your words in our lives, that when men are casting down, our own testimony will be lifting up. Thank you because not allow us to beg for bread, you not allow us to beg for water. Thank you, Lord God Almighty, for your protection. Thank you, Father, Lord God Almighty, for all those things that we could not even begin to count. Father, take all glory in Jesus' name. Lord, we commit the remaining days left in this month of thy care. Lord, you will see us through. In the mighty name of Jesus. Even as we peep into the month of April. The month of April will be our best month ever in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord God Almighty, is going to be our month of progress, our month of breakthrough. Father, Lord God Almighty, our month of renewal, that financially you will make a turnaround in our life. Father, earthwise, spiritually, we shall continue to march on. And the gate of hell shall not prevail over us in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, all our hanging blessings in the month of April, you will release unto us in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, in that month of April, we decree that we shall live and we shall not die. We shall fulfill our destiny in the land of the living. Thank you for answering us. The token we have offered unto you, Lord, let it be acceptable unto you. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. The band, please.
I've come before you today, and that's just one thing that I want to say. We say thank you, Lord, for all you've given to us, for all the blessings that we can receive. We say thank you, Lord. We'll be there for the hearts, lost in the place. We can find the time, I'll bless your name. We'll say thank you, thank you. We'll say thank you, Lord, thank you, Lord.
Thank you very much. God bless us all in the mighty name of Jesus. As we take the next hymn, Sevdina envelope shall be taken. Sevdina envelope.
Thanks be to God for giving us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, indeed, for granting us the spirit of discipline, the grace, the knowledge, the intuition, the mercy and compassion to deny ourselves, take up our cross daily and follow thee. May we evermore be with you and you with us. Emmanuel, O God with us, that together, as you have taught us, as you have led the way, we may sing and shout and praise in victory as you continue to seal us and help us and use us through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Let us sit back. Once again, we return all thanks to God Almighty for making today a reality. This is the day which the Lord has made, another Palm Sunday. We pray that may He continue to preserve us and lead us aright in Jesus' name. Amen. For many Palm Sundays to come, may He continue to preserve our lives in Jesus' name. I congratulate you as well as myself, and I pray that His glory will continue to radiate in our lives in Jesus' name. Let me welcome specially all those who are worshiping with us for the first time. Please, if you are a first timer in the house, can we please meet you as you stand? Any first timer in the house, please stand and let us welcome you. And if there is none, God will continue to bless His church. We welcome those watching with us, better stay joining us online. We say hi to you, and we pray that God will continue to bless you really good in Jesus' name. We run through our notices from page 16. March community singing comes up today, and I'd like to appreciate all March celebrants for heeding the call, because we know that usually it's supposed to come up at the end of the month, but we know that next Sunday is going to be heavy. That is Easter. Our best bet is to have it today. Thank you very much. God bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. So we run it immediately after 10 o'clock service by the grace of God. We are on break for our house fellowship because of the Holy Week. By the grace of God, we shall soon return back. Celebration of Jesus continues on Tuesday by the grace of God at 9 a.m. Please, let's find time to be here. And also know that in His presence holds in the cathedral on Wednesday by the grace of God, 10 a.m. From tomorrow, we know that 5:30 p.m. we are here for various activities later for this week. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, which is the Monday, Thursday, and Friday. We shall be running two services at 9 a.m. Yoruba and 12 noon English, respectively. On Sunday is the D-Day. God Almighty will spare our lives. We shall witness this year's Easter Sunday in the mighty name of Jesus. Served in our envelope, please. The period is winding down. Please let's just try as much as possible to turn in our envelopes. Our Easter Thanksgiving, we are pleading with president of various societies to please help us collect. And those who are in Vika Society, that's the Legbeles, kindly pay to the PAO, or better still, visit the account office, and you will make the payment and necessary thing will be done. 2024 Diocesan Synod, the third session of the sixth synod, is around the corner from 23rd of May to 27th of May. Let's continue to lift up our diocesan and all members of the synod for a successful synod. Confirmation class, by the grace of God, starts on the 7th of April. Please, if you desire to be part of the class, please obtain your form from Reverend Olaitan Adekole. And please let us also note that if you are not 12 already, you are not yet 12 years old, please don't bother to collect the form. Don't bother to collect the form. From 12 upward. Thank you. A parish subcommittee chairman has been listed on page 17 and 18. Please, let's continue to pray for these ones that as they do the work, God Almighty will back them up in the mighty name of. I believe we are saved. Yes. Today is Palm Sunday. Abby? So we cannot run away from hearing such noise. So 17 and 18, please, let's continue to pray for them. Stewardship and Harvest Committee, this is to all societies, please let us react. The talk shop is open, Place of Liberty, and the account number to be paid into on pages 14, on page 8, on page 18, item 14.2. And those who desire to join the acolyte, kindly meet with Venerable KK Ogundile, and those planning for occasional service, please obtain your form and return same to the office at least 2 weeks so that the choir can get prepared. Admission into Lagos Anglican Schools, Igbobi College, and Canon James Pierce Anglican College, Iwaya. Obituary for Mama Bantefa Pafolami Pakuti, former vicar, the Right Reverend Dr. Solomon Betugo Kukbonu, by the grace of God, Songs Tribute, that will be held here on the 12th of April, by the grace of God, and the funeral details also on page 20. For Papa Weshika, Pa Olayemin, and Mama Olayoye, whom we heard about our demise last week. Appreciation from Mrs. Caroline Oluremi Ogundekwe, appreciating all the clergy, the choir, the director of music, the YWCA choir, Elders Fellowship, and to you all for your prayers and gifts extended to her
during her 80th birthday held recently. And she prays that God will continue to be with us all in Jesus' name. Please, expectedly, our usual practice is to go out during 7:30, but I've consulted widely that our best bet is to stitch it down today while we try as much as possible to join our counterpart at 10 o'clock. And this is coming very late, more especially because we are meant to have sensitized our counterpart at 10 o'clock to come very early. And what we intend to do is to appeal to you passionately that please, if you don't mind, we want you to exercise some patience while on the dot of 10 we all go out together. And by implication, what that means is, if God Almighty preserve our lives, we shall be here next year by the grace of God. I can't hear your amen. And if we are also here, now what we intend to do going forward is to sensitize our counterpart at 10 o'clock to come to church between 9 and 9:30, so that by the time we finish our own service, we all move out together. We do what we want to do. We come back. You go to your homes while we continue with our 10 o'clock service. That's what we shall be doing from next year by the grace of God. But for this year, please bear with us. And if you will not be able to wait, please, you have access to the palm fronds. We are going to bless it for you because you want to go home. Nobody is going to gag you. But I'm making this passionate appeal that please exercise patience. For 10, we all go out. Next year, we tidy it much more better. And God will continue to bless us in the mighty name of Jesus. Are we together? Thank you very much for obliging me. God bless us all. Birthday celebrants for this week, please, can we have you? Birthday celebrants, please come forward. Birthday celebrants, please come forward and let us sing for you. Oh. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Almighty God. May you never know a better yesterday in Jesus' name. Hearty congratulations, sir.
Shall we take one moment to recognize, to identify, to continue, to yield and vow our allegiance to our Lord who has branded us his forever? Even by that symbolic act of riding in lowly pomp into majesty, to die, to suffer, to rise, to reign in glory. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Go in peace and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ, amen.